And I'll have the salmon salad.
Very good, madam. And to drink?
Iced tea.
And you, sir?
Can I get a burger or something? I know it's not on the menu, but...
I am sure the chef can approximate a burger, if that is what sir prefers.
Sir prefers.
And to drink?
Coffee.
I believe sir misunderstood. Would you care for something to drink?
Yes, I'll have a coffee.
Sir, coffee is considered by the cafe to be an after-lunch beverage, to be served with perhaps a nice chocolate mousse or a creme brulee, should sir be so inclined. Unless sir would prefer a popsicle, which I'm sure we can find at the local 7-Eleven.
Do you have coffee?
Very well, sir knows best what sir wants. Nonetheless, coffee is not a drink.
Peter.
All right. I swear I've seen that waiter before.
Waiters go from restaurant to restaurant. I wouldn't be surprised if we've seen him before somewhere else.
Yeah, probably America's most wanted.
It doesn't matter. What matters is... I wanted to have a nice brunch and talk to you about, well, about work, really. I took kind of a break while we worked things out between us. And I think we've made some real progress. I think this is where we both need to be, together.
I agree.
Good, because I need to start getting back to work. Like you, I have my career, and that may mean going away for a while. But I won't go if it'll tear us apart again.
MJ, I... To answer your question, would you wait for me knowing I was going out to deal with this?
Of course I would. You know I would. I'd wait for you as long as it took for you to come back.
Then I will wait for you. For as long as it takes for you to get back, MJ. But only for the rest of my life. Anything beyond that, we have to negotiate. Deal?
Deal. Go get him, sweetie.
Ah, my sugar.
No, it's all set. He'll be giving an award to the local boys and girls club tomorrow at noon. I've got it covered. Don't worry. One shot. That's all I need. The kill shot. That's all I ever needed. Just make sure the money's in place. Right. I'll call when it's done. Well?
Nothing to do with you. Just another one of those police chases.
Good. So... Is it ready?
There. A work of art. I took it in a little in the back. Gives it a tapered look. Very trim. I thought you wouldn't mind.
Perfect. It's a killer. That's for sure.
So what are you gonna do about it, Grandpa?
What do you mean, what am I gonna do about it? What's to do?
But you heard him.
It's none of our business. What a client does outside is between them, the police, and God. Who am I to judge?
But this isn't something he did before he got here. This is something he's gonna do if you don't stop him.
And what am I gonna do, Michael? My business depends on guaranteeing privacy for my customers. It's the promise I make to each of them, good and bad. I break that once, my business goes belly up. Worse still, if he gets away, he'll come here. And I can't protect you from someone like that. I can't get involved.
Dad once said you used to tell him stories about how your dad used to watch people passing him by when he was in that camp in Poland, and he just wanted one of them, any of them, to look at him, to get involved. He said that you said the most cowardly thing a man could do is not get involved when something wrong was being done to someone. Somebody's gonna die tomorrow if you don't do something, Grandpa. And you're the only one who knows. Dad used to say...
I know what he said. I know what he would say. And it's that kind of talk that got him killed. I can't put other people first. I can't do for them if it means risking you, Mikey. I just can't. There's nothing I can do. I can't get involved.
Ah, my sugar.
Could tonight be any more dead? Not that I'm complaining, of course. Well, okay, I am complaining. It's just that I shouldn't complain. A quiet night is a peaceful night. A peaceful night is a good night. And a good night is a night when I'm not bored out of my brain. I could go back home, hang with MJ, but I know the second I decide to go home, something always happens. So maybe that's the trick. Well, it's awfully quiet tonight. Yep, awfully quiet. Might as well head home. Nice warm bed, nice warm cup of hot chocolate, nice warm wife. Yep, no reason to stay out here in the dark and the cold. Oh well, I guess it doesn't always.
Hey, up there, Mr. Bug Guy. Down here.
Mr. Bug Guy?
What, you got webs in the ears? Hello?
You talking to me?
What, you see another bug guy anywhere around here? Yeah, you.
You're talking to me.
I'm talking to you.
This had better be good. I'm very busy.
Yeah, I can see that.
So what's the problem?
It's... you have to stand like that? You can't talk to somebody like a normal person?
It's a lifestyle thing. Go on.
Somebody's gonna be killed tomorrow. I'm pretty sure it's the district attorney. It's gonna happen at some big award they're giving at the Boys and Girls Club.
Yeah? How do you know?
It's a long story, and I'm cold. You got a place we can go? Like some kind of spider cave, or an underground mansion, or...
I got a place.
You got a place?
I got a place.
This bayou is a place?
You don't like it?
It's just a little exposed, you know? If somebody sees me talking to
Don't worry. I came here a couple months ago around Halloween. The guy who works the counter figured it was just a costume. When I kept coming back the same way, he decided I'm just some nut who thinks he's Spider-Man. Watch. Hey, I'm Spider-Man, right? Tell the guy I'm Spider-Man.
Yeah, sure, you're Spider-Man. And I'm Dorothy. Just a minute, while I get my red freaking shoes on.
See? Now, how did
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Who did your costume?
I don't...
See, I'm looking at your costume.
Uniform?
Whatever. And it's... well, it's not very good, is it? I mean, it says spider, and that's all you wanted to say. That's terrific. Who am I to judge? As a symbol, it makes a statement. But as a piece of clothing, not so good. For starters, you want to eat, you got to pull up the mask. Very inconvenient.
Wait a second.
The fabric, I'm guessing spandex or something like that. You overheat a lot in this thing, don't you? You got no weatherproofing, no proper ventilation. You could get athlete's foot all over your body in a thing like this. So who designed it?
I did.
Well, see, there's your problem. You want a job done right, you go to a professional. That's me. That's who I am, what I do, and how I come to know what I know. The name's Leo Zelinsky. I'm a tailor. I got a nice little shop down on 23rd Street near 8th. We don't get a lot of walk-in traffic. But there was one night, about 5-6 years ago.
You want to give a guy a hand here? I was just in a fight with these guys, then there was this blast, and... you got something to the 70 waist. And I gotta have stretch in the inseam or I chafe.
I'll see what I can do. After that, word got around. My business depends on word of mouth, same as everybody else. A friend tells a friend. Next thing I know, I'm up to my tokas in spandex. It was an honor to serve. Legends from when I was a boy. I've seen them all. A bunch of the Avengers, the X-Guys, had Daredevil in a couple of times. I give them all the privacy they want, have them come in the back way so there's no danger of being exposed. I even help some of them come up with costumes and ideas.
I want to be the wolf.
It's too generic. Besides, there's already a Wolverine out there. You want to be different, be your own person. Everybody wants to be some kind of wolf. It's strictly yesterday. How about the ferret? Ever seen a ferret? My niece, she's got two. Very cute, very smart, very tough.
But I don't want to be the ferret.
Just think about it. That's all I'm saying. Like I said, word got around. Thing is, word gets to all kinds of people. Some good, some not so much.
Fix it.
And it's not like you can argue, right?
Wait a minute. You work for the good guys and the bad guys? And you don't see anything wrong with this?
A guy goes into a restaurant, orders a cheese sandwich. You give it to him. Does that make the guy behind the counter a bad guy? Good guys, bad guys, we all gotta eat. We all gotta wear clothes. Though some days, that works out better than other days.
So I'm thinking of just wearing a thong from now on, like those sumo wrestlers. What do you think?
Because some of my clients don't get along with some of my other clients, I decided to break it up. I see heroes Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. Bad guys I see Tuesdays and Thursdays. It's mostly after hours in my shop downstairs, but I made it real comfortable. Got things to read while they wait. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays, I put out Time, Newsweek, the papers. Tuesdays and Thursdays, I put out Gun Magazine, Penthouse. Thor, very nice guy, wears a 56 long. Snug on him, but that's how he likes it. Reads gardening magazines and Modern Bride.
So is there a point to any of this?
One of my new customers calls himself Killshot. I don't know real names. I heard him talking on the phone about shooting someone at the award presentation tomorrow. My guess is the DA. What they do before they come to me is none of my business. But this is gonna happen unless I do something. I need someone who's not a client. Someone who can just stumble across the situation and deal with it. Doesn't hurt that you're from the neighborhood.
Why come to me? Why not tell the police?
Good or bad, all my clients demand total privacy. If I tell the police, they'll come around asking questions, and my clientele would disappear.
So how do you know I'm from around here?
Yeah, go ahead. Ask me again with that Queens accent how I know you're from the neighborhood.
Look, bug guy. Everybody who comes to the city for more than an hour, suddenly they're all talking like Tony Soprano. Could have a nice little something there. Events, maybe a mouthpiece, could close with Velcro, leave it open.
Main thing is, I don't want this to come back to haunt me. Not so much for myself, but I got a grandson I gotta look out for. I don't want him to get hurt. And I don't want him to think his grandfather didn't do the right thing when it counted. So don't screw it up. For starters, you want to eat. You gotta pull up your mask. Very inconvenient.
You have got to stop having coffee so late at night.
I'm hip.
We are very pleased to present this award to one of the most deserving citizens, District Attorney Sam Whitehall.
Thank you. It's an honor to receive this award for citizenship from such an important organization. The Boys and Girls Club of America has been instrumental in helping guide the youth of tomorrow.
What the?
I keep telling you, if you can't play nice with others, we're gonna have to take your toys away.
Yeah, well, I've got more where that came from.
You know, somebody who's supposed to be such a good shot, you have a hard time hitting the target.
Not true. I hit exactly what I was aiming at.
What are you... Oh, jeez. This time is just right.
Very nice, Mike. But you may want to keep the fabric tight as it goes through the sewing machine so it doesn't bunch up. Here, let me show you.
This is your fault.
Mr. Killshot?
Shut up! Nobody knew about the job but my employer. You heard me talking to him, didn't you? Who else did you talk to?
Look, I'm telling you the truth.
Right, Grandpa. Now.
Oh, run, Mikey, run!
Oh, that's twice today you made me miss. But you know what they say. Third time's the charm.
Everybody down! I've got him! I just happened to be passing by the ceremony and saw the reflection of his gun.
Well, I'm glad you did, or I wouldn't be here right now. Funny thing, though. The suspect said you ran some kind of secret business here. That you knew in advance what was going on. Said we should search the place. Though if what he's saying is true, then that means I owe both of you my life. But what are the odds on that, right? Come on, boys. We've got better things to do. Have a good day, fellas.
Hey, anytime you need a little nip and tuck, you know where to find me.
You going to be okay now?
Yeah, I think so. The clients will raise an eyebrow, but the way it went down, thanks to you, I don't think they'll ask too many questions.
Grandpa Leo saved my life.
Yes, he did. You know why? Because clothes don't make heroes. What makes a hero is what happens in your heart.
It's really corny, you know that? You sound like my teachers.
Sorry, he's excited, that's all.
It's okay, he's got a point.
A little thank you for this, for saving my business, me, just for everything. I designed something for you if you ever want to upgrade to a better look. I'll give you a good price.